first treasure, the heavenly portal, the point where the teacher placed his finger upon your face during the ceremony, is called the heavenly portal. It is the abode of your true self and can be described in different ways, such as 1. Original nature. This is the true self, soul, or conscience, which is eternal and indestructible. 2. The portal of birth and death. The heavenly portal is the door by which our original nature enters and leaves our body. Confucius asked, "Who can leave the house without using the door? Why do people not follow this way?" 3. The way to heaven. A Buddhist sutra says, "Heaven is 108,000 miles away." These words are the metaphor which actually means that it was not easy to become enlightened because the true teacher was difficult to find and the Tao was not yet widely propagated. Without the proper understanding of the Tao, heaven seems very far away, but with a real understanding of the Tao, heaven is very near. Today your teacher has pointed out the way for you and you may now ascend to heaven with one step.
第三章，何谓三宝经？天，你们所得之至宝，亦可称为三宝。一玄观，二口诀，三合同。一第一宝，玄观，玄观玄妙莫测之门。玄观点传师向你们指点之处，它有许多名称，一点本性，此是我本来固有的真我灵性良心。它是不毁不灭的，它永远存在。二点生死之门户，玄观是灵性出入身体之门户。孔子曰，谁能出不由户，何莫由斯道也。三点通天大陆，佛经云，西天十万八千里，此是譬喻，亦成佛是不义之事，因为名师难访，大道还未普传。然而名师经已指点明明路，你一步登天。四点，
the main entrance, the heavenly portal is the main entrance. It is situated at the center and not to the left or right, above or below. This entrance was locked after your imperishable spirit entered the body at birth. If the heavenly portal is not unlocked by your teacher,your true self is not able to leave the body by the main entrance at the time of death. Instead, it will have to leave by one of the side gates, A. The eyes, B. The ears, C. The mouth, D. The nose, E. The navel, F. The vertex. If your spirit leaves from the ears, it is reborn as a viviparous animal, such as a horse, pig, cow, sheep, etc. The eyes, it is reborn as an oviparous bird. The mouth, it is reborn as a creature of the water, such as a fish, a lobster, etc. The nose, it is reborn as an insect, such as a fly, a moth, a bee, etc. E. Navel, it is reborn as an ordinary person. F. Vertex, it is reborn as a wealthy and powerful person. 4.
正门玄关是正门，它正好位于当中，不偏向左也不偏向右，不在上也不在下。当灵性投入身体后，自门关闭了。假如我们不遇名师指开玄关，临终时我们的灵性将无正门可出离身体。 他只能由其他旁门出去，眼耳口鼻肚其顶门。如果灵性走旁门，亦由耳而出者，来生当为胎生之动物，如马、猪、牛、羊之类。二由眼而出者，来生当为卵生之动物，如飞鸟之类。三由口而出者，来生当为食生之动物，如鱼虾之类。四由鼻而出者，来生当为化生之动物，如苍蝇蜜蜂之类。五由肚脐而出者，来生当为平庸之人。六由顶门而出者，来生当为富贵之人。上述之路乃生死轮回之路，不能脱出生死之苦。点传师点开玄关正门，这是通天之路，我们不必再走四门，不必再坠入轮回受苦。但是我们必须要真修，否则玄关虽开，我们的灵性仍不能返天，因我们还是充满罪恶，灵性为罪恶所是不能自由从正门而出的。五点。
In the Bible, Matthew 13:11, John said to his disciples, I baptize you with water to show that you have repented, but that one who will come after me will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. The vow is transmitted to you in the temple of God through God's sanction and commandment.The holy lamp on the altar symbolizes God. In the transmittal ritual, the teacher uses the incense to lead a line of fire from the holy lamp to your heavenly portal. Then, using his finger, he connects God's spirit with your spirit so that they flow together as one.Thereby enlightening you with God's Spirit. This is the actual fulfillment of John's prophecy. 5.
圣经上记载约翰对他的门徒说，我用水给你们施洗，表明你们已悔改。然而在我之后的将用圣灵与火给你们施洗。请记忆，你们是在上帝的宫殿里得到，因为我们有上帝的天命，那盏佛灯代表上帝了。在点道之仪式中，你们已见到点传师以香柱从佛灯引来一条经指向你们的玄关。然后借点传师的手指点在你们的玄关之时，上帝一一的圣灵已点开了你们的心窍，照破了黑暗。现在你们可见到约翰之预言已经实现在你们身上。
Satyam Muni Buddha said, I have the great Dharma which is hidden in the eyes. This indicates the location of the heavenly portal. 6.
释迦牟尼佛云，无有正法掩藏此语，暗示玄关之底。
Be the second treasure, the divine mantra 1.You have now been given the divine mantra. It is very important to remember it as it will save your life. It is only to be used in extremely dangerous situations. This mantra acts as a powerful spiritual distress signal to the divine forces, much like an SOS transmitted by radio waves. It is to be projected mentally and silently with great concentration while at the same time focusing the eyes on the heavenly portal and holding the symbolic seal with the hands. Powerful aid will immediately be sent to you in order to rescue you from danger. If you sincerely cultivate yourself, you will always remain under the refuge of Buddha.
二第二宝口诀：心经或五字真经。一刚才传授口诀给你们，还记得吗？请再说一遍。当性命危险时，你才用此宝，将真经默念口中，手抱合同。你将可被仙佛救护，脱离危险。不过要注意，此口诀仅能于性命危急之时方可运用。假若我们真诚修道，当然我们将受仙佛之庇佑。
The divine mantra which connects your true self with God. This mantra is without form, sound or color and is the essence of Tao, the underlying and ultimate principle of the universe. This mantra unites your being with that of the Tao, forming a powerful bond. Every great religion indicates this potential unity, but they do not fully understand how to implement and effect it. You now have this knowledge and are familiar with its application.
二心经，口传心授由声音而达入无声因果之真心，由千经万点而达入真经真点，心经心法真空也，真我本性也。三点。
The true teaching is transmitted from mind to mind. The true self, the I, the spirit, the mind all indicate the true center of man or his real essence and original indestructible nature which is identical with Tao. The human being is a microcosm, sharing all the attributes of the macrocosm. Since he is essentially divine, man only needs to understand the nature of reality and align himself with it. The more pure and refined his nature, the more conscious he becomes of his relationship with the Tao. When he realizes that he is one with the Tao, he has become fully enlightened.
三以心传心口传心手，以老之心传于众生之真心，此者老的分灵之心也。
See, the third treasure, the symbolic seal one. In Chinese, Fa means to combine and Dun means all together. The symbolic seal which is formed by the two hands joined together is the golden seal which is formed by the two hands joined together is the golden seal which unites us with God. It is like a contract or mutual agreement which is the actual meaning of Hatun between you and your heavenly mother. It acts as a signal, password, or passport. It is a spiritual instrument of identification, as well as symbol with many ramifications. 2. When you hold the symbolic seal, you are united with God. 3. The left hand is good, so it is placed on the outside, covering the right hand. The right hand is often used for evil purposes, such as beating and killing. The right hand is placed on the inside because of its evil propensities and is shielded by the left hand. Together the hands hold the word child, which is formed by the two thumbs in proximity, symbolizing the Chinese word hai, which means child. This hand symbol acts as a direct signal to God. It serves to mobilize heavenly protection and causes the user to escape from any impending calamity. 4. Let us quote some words from the Bible, Matthew 19:13-15. Some people brought children to Jesus for him to place his hands on and to pray for them, but the disciples scolded the people. Jesus said, "Let the children come to me and do not stop them, because the kingdom of heaven belongs to them." He placed his hands on them and then went away. This event illustrates the power and significance of the symbolic seal. At that time Jesus placed his hands on the children's heads and explained that this is the way to God's kingdom. Today we hold the child symbol and realize that we are the children of God and are willing to return to God's presence.
3. 第3宝盒同一点和同之意和是合成一体。 同是相同，合同象征老赐予我们的精印，表示我们已归根人。我们手抱合同，表示我们要与老合成一体，同老一样，是说与老和灵永不再分开。2. 点和合同，同同合。 抱起合同，能闭眼罗。3. 点左手数扇当在外，右手数轭鞠那边，子害将掐怀中抱，能脱酒大大节冠。4. 现在让我们应用圣经之语句，有一些人带孩子们到耶稣跟前求耶稣为他们按手祝福，但是使徒们则被那些人耶稣说让孩子们到我这里来，不要阻止他们，因为上帝的国是属于如此的人。耶稣为他们按手祝福，然后离开。 从这件事，我们可了解它是对合同之一种预言。在那时，耶稣把手按在孩子头上，并说：“须如此方能返回天国。”如今我们手抱子海觉，并觉悟我们是上帝的儿女，且愿意回返上帝身边。
Chapter 4. Why do the introducer and the sponsor take an oath?